the definition of appropriate. Like, not like what does it mean to be appropriate, but like how do we know what is appropriate? It's super interesting because, you know, we say things like, you know, you never have to speak harshly to someone. You know, we live in this like very like non-judgmental, we can't be judgmental, we shouldn't be judgmental, you know, and then you look around the world and then there's like a lot of judgment. And if you don't talk this way, then you have that problem. But if you say this thing, then there's another thing. And it becomes very confusing to know sort of what we can and can't do. And when there's confusion, so oftentimes people just disengage. This week's Torah portion has this really interesting thing because you see Pinchas, who in the end of last week's Torah portion actually kills two people that are like sitting terribly, right? And you're like, well, that was uncomfortable. And not only does he not get in trouble for that, but he's rewarded and God calls him, like he's gonna make a covenant of peace with him, right? So you're like, what, how does that work? And it's very interesting because when there's sort of a general approach to life, a general approach to how things are done, likely that's not gonna work. Even if it works 80% of the time, a person has to stay dynamic. A person has to ask themselves consistently, what's the right solution? Even if, and again, Judaism talks a lot about this, there are times to actually be sad. There are times to be happy. There are times to be upset, right? There are times to fight. There are times to love, times for peace, right? So as long as we have a general rule, it's probably never gonna work. But if we're able to really look to the best of our ability, even if it's uncomfortable, and a lot of times it is uncomfortable, what's actually needed at this time? What do I really have to do? If you're able to have that definition and you're able to have that idea that we're not going to just hit this again within life and business and marriage and everything, really, there are times when it's smooth and times it's difficult. There are times when things work well, there are times when things work terrible, right? And if you have that ability to appreciate that I have to stay present and I have to stay what's appropriate for right now, even if it's not what I'm comfortable with, even if it's not what I've been doing, ultimately, that's how we stay in a place that is good and righteous. And if we just kind of this, you know, carte blanche way of being, right, that's when things get, unfortunately, very uncomfortable. Thank you very much. Good Shabbos.